Hello friends, welcome back to RMK Resolutions. Again, the next agricultural pest we are going to learn in this particular video. In the previous few video, we learned about this agricultural pest, household pest, and some veterinary and nursery pest. Again, we discussed the red cotton bug and jowar stem borer in a previous few videos. So please do watch all these video for the complete understanding of the agricultural pest. Now here we are going to discuss about the brinjal fruit borer, or it is also known as a brinjal stem borer. So the classification or scientific classification on your screen, and on the right hand side of your screen, this one is the moth for the brinjal stem borer. Just a minute. Yes. So this particular moth, here the systematic position, they are coming in the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Pyralidae, genus Lysinodes, and species Orbanalis. So this one is the scientific classification or systematic position of this brinjal stem borer or brinjal fruit borer we have learned. Now, as I told you, this particular brinjal stem borer, the common name is the brinjal shoot borer or brinjal fruit borer. So that name itself indicate the host plant for this pest is the brinjal plant. And we know that brinjal plant, it is a very important, economically important plant. And if this particular moth, they damage the brinjals in a severe amount, then it create a health issues, because that fruit is unfit for the eating also, unfit for the human being eating also, and that also destroy the economic wealth of the farmers. That's why it is important to learn this particular moth. So again, I am going to discuss this particular insect pest by first discussing about the host plant, then we'll discuss the identification mark, then we'll discuss the life cycle and nature of damage, and finally we deal with the control measure of this pest. Now let's go to the host plant. So as I told you, this particular brinjal is the main host, and other solanaceous plant and peas, these are the alternative for this pest. So the scientific name, we already, the genus name is the Lysinodes orbanalis. This is the most important and destructive pest of the brinjal, and they are countrywide, they having a countrywide distribution. Now let's go for the identification mark of this pest. So the moth, you can see here, this particular moth, it is medium size moth, and they grow up to near about 20 mm across when they spread their wings. So they grow near about the 20 mm, and their head and thorax are blackish brown in color. You can see here, this one is the head and thorax, which is blackish or brown, blackish brown in color. We can see here, this one is the head part, head portion of the insect, and this one is the thoracal portion of the insect, which is blackish brown in color. These are the antenna, these are the spread wings of the insect, and this one is the abdominal portion of the insect. We know that insect, they are divided into the head, thorax, and abdominal regions. So as I told you, the head and thorax, they are blackish or brownish in color. The wings are white in color. So this is an identification mark. Wings are white in color and they're provided with the small hairs along the apical and anal margin. So we can observe here, this is again identification mark. See towards this pointer. On the margin of the wing, there are small hair-like structure we can see. Then there are number of black, pale, light brown spots are found on the forewings and hind wings of the moth. Then caterpillar, it is pale white. Caterpillar means larva. It is pale white. We will see here. This one is the larva, which is the destructive. So this particular larva or caterpillar, it is pale white in color and they are grown near about 12 mm long when they are fully grown. You can see this one is the caterpillar larva, which is whitish in color or pale whitish in color. Or pale whitish means it is slightly yellowish in color, we can say light yellow. Okay, so these are the some identification marks of brinjal fruit borer or brinjal stem borer. So we can easily identify by observing the external characteristics. Okay, let's move towards the life cycle of this moth. You can see here on your screen, this is a very important, beautiful pictures. How this particular larvae, they are also known as the brinjal stem borer, because they are going to attack larva or caterpillar. They are going to attack on the stem of the brinjal plant and they eat the pith cell within a stem and they are going to form a dead heart. So this is a very destructive larva for the brinjal. So these are the some pictures which shows the caterpillar. They are going to damage the stem. Now this one, this picture shows the life cycle of this insect pest. So we'll discuss the life cycle. So moth, first obviously this particular female, they are going to lay the eggs. So first we'll discuss the the characteristics of the eggs. So moth, they laid the eggs, elongated eggs. So remember, this particular eggs, they are elongated egg, and near about 250 eggs are laid, and this particular eggs are laid singly. Their legs, eggs are not laid in a cluster. They are singly or in a small batches on the leaf surface. So eggs are laid on the surface. Then eggs are also laid on the shoot of the brinjal plant, or the eggs are laid on the fruit also. So these particular eggs, they are hatched in 3 to 5 days, and after hatching, the caterpillar, they are emerge from the eggs, or larva is emerge after 3 to 5 days, and they start boring into the shoots. They make a boring means they make a hole into the shoots, or they boring into the leaf midribs or petioles of the flower or into the fruits, and they feed on the internal tissue. So from larva, from the eggs, larvas are emerged, and larva, they start boring to the different parts of the brinjal fruit, a brinjal plant. So as I told you, this particular larva, they undergo, this particular larva, which we look, segmented larva. Segmentation is important phenomenon for the insect. So this particular larva, they undergo the molting. Phyomolting takes place in a 10 to 15 days. We know that molting means it is the shedding of the skin. So five molting takes place within 10 to 15 days, and fifth instar larva, it is stout pink in color. So after fifth molting, that fifth instar larva is stout pink in color, and that is major near about 1.6 centimeter in length. So pupation after larva, pupation phenomenon begins. So pupation takes place in a cocoon on the plant. So they are going to produce a cocoons, and that pupation stage, it lasts for 6 to 8 days. Then moth lives for 2 to 5 days, and female, they lay near about 250 eggs, and these eggs are laid on the surface of the leaves or fruits or on the shoot. So larva is parasite by Pristomurus testacus. So this is the life cycle of the brinjal fruit borer or brinjal stem borer. Again, this picture shows the life cycle again, so no need to discuss separately. So as I told you, this particular pupa, it is grayish boat shaped cocoons they are going to produce. It, the shape of the cocoon is looking like a boat, and the pupal period is near about 7 to 8 days. Then these are the some points regarding the adults. Adults, their forewings are has black and brown patches, we have already discussed, and they having a dots of on the white color. So adult, they are major near about 20 to 22 millimeter across the wings. Okay, so these picture which are on your screen, which shows the 50 to 90% damage caused by the fruit and shoot borer. Here shoot is going to damage, you can see here, these are the shoot wings, these are the growing stem. So this particular shoot is damaged. So this particular larva, you can see here, see carefully, this particular larva, they make a tunnel into the shoot, and they eat the pith, cell pith, that is the internal tissue, and they destroy this particular shoot. And if shoots are damaged, then whole plant is, their viability get damaged. So plants are not viable. Here, this is the fruit damage. So if eggs are laid on the fruits, then this particular caterpillar, they make a tunnel or hole on a brinjal fruit, and they eat the internal portion, internal cells. And again, that fruit is unfit for the human consumption. And here in the middle portion of this diagram or figure, it shows the adult moth. Okay, so this is about the some damage. So nature of damage, as I already told you, larval stage, it is the only destructive stage. Adult stage, they are not destructive, but adult, they are laid the eggs. But larval stage is the most destructive stage, because they destruct or damage the shoot, they damage the fruit also. So as I told you, this larva, they bore into the tender shoots, and infected shoot drop down and ultimately dry up. So larva, they bore into the flower buds also, and developing fruits under the calyx, they leaving no visible sign of infections. Then attack fruits, they shows the hole in on the fruits. And in case of the severe infection in the initial stage, they may having a no fruiting at all. So fruits are not developing, major infection in a initial stage of the plant. So the pinkish larva, they make a zigzag tunnel. So see, you can see here, this one is a pinkish larva, stock pink larva, which make a zigzag tunnel into the fruits, and fruits are hold. And such fruits are, as I told you, not fit for the human consumption. So near about 70% loss of the crop takes place when this particular pest is going to attack. So this is the huge damage for the farmers. 70% of the crop is get damaged. So let's see the management of this pest, how we are going to control this particular pest. So first is the cultural method. It is also known as traditional method. So crop rotation, this is a beneficial as the insects survive only on the brinjal. So crop rotation, this is a very important traditional method for controlling this insect pest. Then intercropping brinjal with other crops. Intercropping means in between of the brinjal, some other plants we can grow like cowpea, maize or coriander, which improves the natural habitat for the natural enemies like spider, lace wings, then different mites against this pest. So if you take an intercrop like cowpeas, maize or coriander, then some other enemies, natural enemies of natural enemies of brinjal stem borer, they come over there like a spiders, and they are going to eat this particular insect pest. So this is the cultural method, or we can say this method is also known as biological method, intercropping. Then collection, destruction of dried shoot tips or the tender shoot tips and fruit borer foods. So collection of the damaged parts of the plant. So this is again a method. So this is an efficient method because larvae tends to pupate in a plant residues only. So further infection, further spread of the infection we can avoid by collection and destruction of this infected portion of the plant. Then as I told you, there are some biological methods, natural enemies against this particular brinjal fruit stem borer, which is reported in India. So these are the predators for the brinjal fruit stem borer. These are the bugs and some beetles. They are the natural predators. Then parasitoideas are also there. And these are the some fungus which are again effective for this pest. Fungal or this particular nuclear virus are also effective for this pest. And lastly, the chemical methods. So chemicals are used here. So soil is applicable with carbofuran, which is of 3 g at 30 kg per hectare, and 10 days after transplanting it is very effective. Then cultivation of brinjal under the protected cultivation, that is the net house condition, it is found to reduce the incidence of shoot and fruit borer. Again, the next thing, next chemical method, spray any one of the different chemicals such as the these are the insecticides, remember. So these insecticides are also used, carbosulfan, then spinosad, profenophos. So this is the concentration which is given over here. So these are the some effective chemical method to control the brinjal stem borer. Okay, so in this particular thing, this is the chemical method, but nowadays some BT plants are coming that we have not discussed, but this is again some effective methods, that BT plants, BT brinjals, BT cottons are there. So this is an BT means biotechnology, means this genetically engineered plant, we can say. That is also the effective methods. Different resistance varieties are grown by the scientist. BT varieties are grown by the scientist, and that is very effective against these pests. So that is also the method we can say to control this particular pest. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. I hope all of you understand this particular brinjal stem borer or brinjal fruit borer. If you like the video, then please share this particular video to your friends and family. and subscribe RMK Resolutions for more update. Thank you. Bye bye.